Today we're going to go into the gem room with Lance Grande, who is the distinguished curator. I forgot the name.
Distinguished service curator.
Distinguished service curator. And like my position, there's only one.
Well, I'm also the curator of gems by default.
Oh, right.
Which is the connection there.
Yeah, and which is what we're going to go look at today.
You know, gems, they're beautiful in themselves, but they also show human artistry with the designer's work and all the jewelry. But they show natural beauty, too, just with the crystal form.
Yeah.
I mean, some of these I liked even better in their native form than right. after they'd been cut. Mm-hmm. And, you know, since we are a natural history museum, it's an important thing, I think, to pull it into natural history, too.
Yeah.
This stone is a beautiful emerald-colored tourmaline. And it's set okay. in a Victorian setting of, I think it's platinum and diamonds.
Oh my gosh. See,
and this is diamonds in a giant baroque pearl.
That's amazing.
Set in 18 karat white gold.
That's huge.
It
doesn't even look real.
It's real. Don't drop it.
I'll put it on. Oh, that's beautiful. I can see where people are like, oh, I like looking at that.
You see, it's probably a $40,000 ring.
Oh my gosh. This is my college tuition right there. Yeah, I could put that back in.
Here's a tourmaline, but this is a special, it's called a PARAIBA tourmaline. Tourmaline is one of those stones that comes in every color of the rainbow. It colors everything in a lot of these stones. The chemical composition is exactly the same. You know, the only difference is just a trace element
really?
That caused the color to change a little bit. It's the same for diamonds. You have white diamonds, the ones that are clear, and you have red and blue and green and all the colors. And, you know, they're all basically pure carbon with just a trace element in there that gives them this shade.
Yeah.
And again, the differences in value are astounding. You know, a 2-carat white diamond is, you know, it's valuable. You could probably find one for $10,000 of, you know, medium quality. But mm-hmm. a 2-carat red diamond probably cost you $5 million.
Oh my gosh, just because of the rarity?
Just because of the rarity.
Recurrence?
And this is an amethyst, piece of amethyst. Amethyst okay. used to be very rare mm-hmm. and very expensive, but then, a century ago, they found these massive deposits in Brazil.
Really?
And the price of amethyst plummeted. This is another odd piece here.
Yeah, it looks like melted glass.
Yes, it's actually a low-quality emerald.
Really?
Uh-huh. It's if this was a prettier green, it would be totally priceless because it's a very clear piece. Because of the shade, they just lump it together with aquamarine, or sometimes call them
okay.
pale green barrels. But basically, it's the exact same composition as emerald.
Wow.
And it just didn't get quite green enough. If it had, you know, God, I can't imagine how much this would be worth.
Yeah, and they carved it. They carved deer into it.
There are some people who their artistic medium is carving gems, gems like diamonds, which is really difficult because the only thing you can carve
them,
with other diamonds. Here's another PARAIBA tourmaline okay. and diamond necklace. This is a very rare color of tourmaline. Oh, yeah, here's a jadeite necklace. I'm sure how it all fits together even. I this clips on here somewhere, but you have to have a pretty sturdy neck to even wear something like this.
Yeah, is it heavy? Oh, yeah. That is not light.
Not light at all.
This would weigh on you after an evening out at the gala.
What would you compare it to?
How heavy it is?
Yeah.
It.
Like rock.
Yeah, like rock. Like, that's exactly what it is. If you had, mm-hmm. like, if you were wearing 3 dozen marbles around your neck, that's kind of what it feels like.
What is jade, too? And jade is not only heavy, but this is the toughest. Other of the gems.
Really?
Toughness and hardness are completely different qualities. I mean, a diamond is the hardest substance in the universe, but if you drop it on the floor, it could shatter.
Really?
This is much softer than diamond, but if you drop it on the floor, it's not going to break. In fact, they used to make anvils out of this in Asia.
Mm-hmm. I didn't know that.
These are golden pearls. It's a particular species of mollusk that makes it. I believe they're worth a premium over white pearls.
Whoa! Oh,
yeah. Now here's something. This is an expensive piece here.
The others haven't been.
This is about $250,000 necklace here. It's called kunzite. That's what the pink stone is. And then savorite garnet, which is the green, which is one of the rarest and most expensive of the garnets. And Yeah, that's a nice. You want to try and wear it?
Yeah.
There you go.
Katie, you should take that. Oh my gosh.
I think that's it.
Oh my god.
Yeah, there it is. Voila.
How does it look?
There it is. Now you look like $1 million.
I'm probably worth $1 million right about now. This is amazing. Oh my gosh. I feel fancy. I feel like I could just go on the public floor
really
right
well
now.
With the bug earrings too.
I need my butler. Yeah, these were like $10 at H&M. That was the most exciting thing I've probably done all year.
So like here's a bin that just has pearls. These are all pretty sizable pearls. There's pink, white, multicolored. It's like gold and Tahitian and white.
I would just misplace that. Like my little bag of
rubies?
Rubies.
Yeah, this is a little bag of rubies, which are just red sapphires. Here's a light colored.
Wow.
It's almost a white sapphire. It has a certain amount of brilliance. It's not like a diamond.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the other quality of diamond, the way it diffracts light.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it breaks it up into little rainbows. And that's why when you see a really good diamond, you see all these different colors coming from it.
Yeah.
It's the way it handles light. If you look at sapphire, you won't see anything near that. You pretty much just see white flashes when you see it.
It's shiny.
It's shiny, pretty. Sure. Shiny and pretty, but you can make a piece of glass look that way, too.
Oh, yeah.
Another thing we have a lot of is gold. Probably the most common gold we have are these nuggets. There's a sizable gold
nugget. Whoa! That's pretty heavy.
That would be, how many ounces is that? 12 ounces.
Wow. That's pretty heavy.
Figure gold's now $1,300 an ounce.
Yeah.
Crystalline gold is pretty rare. Most raw gold you see in its native form comes in the form of dust or nuggets, but it's very rare to find gold that has actually formed in natural crystal. I think this is a fairly ugly piece of jewelry, but it is gold.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it
needs
it's
to
like
be
interlocking.
Cleaned up.
Yeah.
It's kind of snaky looking.
Yeah. Oh, it is. I like the design of that. But it does look like, you know. It
needs to be cleaned up.
Yeah. See, if this was like in a case at a thrift store, like in one of the front cases, I wouldn't be able to tell that it was fancy gold.
Here's a diamond, just how it came out of the mine, uncut. But you can see how these things look in their native form again.
Oh, wow.
It's a natural diamond crystal.
It's kind of pretty when it's uncut.
Coin that was made in Russia, but it was made a long time ago. It was made at a time when platinum wasn't so valuable, so they actually made it out of platinum and gold plated it.
Oh.
And eventually platinum became more valuable than gold.
Than gold.
And so it's kind of a historic piece.
That's fun. What is that matrix looking thing?
That is a selenite crystal, just a natural crystal.
Wow. It's beautiful.
Isn't it? It's just the way somebody chopped it out of the cave. Here's a piece of boulder opal.
Wow. I've never seen one so blue.
Well, it's actually the reds that are the rarest parts of these. Blue and greens are the more common color in precious opal. If you get blue, green, and red, then it becomes pretty valuable. There's gold, diamonds, rubies, and jadeite. A butterfly pin. That's all solid gold.
Oh my gosh! I don't even know. What would you take this to?
I don't know, but here I can open it for you.
The opera.
There you go.
I guess, yeah, we go to the opera.
You can put your gold coins in there, I guess.
Oh, man. You can just take the purse.
I know. Isn't that strange?
That's amazing. It's so heavy. It's really dense.
And if you had that actually nowadays, no one would believe it was solid gold.
No, I don't even believe that this is solid gold.
They'd probably think, oh, it's some cheap brass thing.
This seems impractical. Like, would my iPhone fit in this? Could we?
It might.
Nope. See, I'm not going to take it because my iPhone
couldn't fit. We have to go back to the iPhone 4 and it would fit.
Oh, yep. See? iPhone 4 users.
And I'm not sure why you need the supplemental purse then, too.
It just...
This is already kind of a change purse. So.
Why would you be carrying loose change if
you could carry
you
your
had
gold nuggets in there? See?
Yeah.
It'd be all gold all the time. Here's a large topaz, blue topaz.
It's like as big as my face.
It's too big for bling.
Yeah. Well, I think I could wear it though. No.
It'd make a nice engagement ring.
Yeah. Right there.
Oh, and here's a really nice aquamarine crystal, natural crystal. Get some sizable stones out of that one if it were cut.
It kind of looks like the things that Superman uses in the Fortress of Solitude.
Oh, yeah, right. Putting them into the council there and
all
the structures pop out of nowhere. These are red garnets here in a schist.
I love the way garnets form. Because they're so cut, they're perfectly cut already.
Isn't that cool? Oh, here's a rose quartz bowl.
Oh, whoa.
This is all carved out of rose quartz.
This one piece?
One piece.
Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh.
That somebody took some time on that.
Yeah.
Oh, and here's a crystal ball carved out of clear quartz.
Oh my God.
It's what they used to use. You're telling fortunes.
Can you tell my fortune? Can you read my future in this crystal ball?
I think you're going to be on YouTube.
It still has brains on it.